Shell calls the wells relatively simple, but will drill them as though they're the most complicated prospecting the company has ever done. Why? Deepwater Horizon and the disaster in the Gulf of Mexico.
We'd have been tone deaf if we had thought that it could be, it would have been business as usual after the Deepwater Horizon.
Could this happen again? Like Shell's Arctic wells, the disastrous Macondo well was exploratory, but Shell, unlike BP, has no plans to bring up oil this summer. It will need a much bigger platform to do that. Shell's wells will be capped and abandoned. The biggest difference, depth. Shell will be drilling in less than 200 feet of water and up to 8,000 feet below the seabed. Deepwater Horizon drilled through 5,000 feet of water, then more than 13,000 feet below the sea floor. The pressure differences, enormous.
The pressures are roughly about a third of what you'd see in a typical deepwater well.
Like all wells, Shell will use blowout preventers. Unlike BP's, Shell's blowout preventers will lie beneath the seabed so a rig can disconnect more safely in case of emergency.
As a part of what happened in the post-Deepwater Horizon world, all these blowout preventers were actually brought back to what we call original equipment manufacturer standards.
In case of a blowout, Shell will have on hand a capping stack. That's what brought an end to the Gulf disaster.
There you go.
For drivers like Aaron Schmafe, who has a mountain of bills and a three-year-old to raise, she thinks there should be room for exploration, but not at the risk of another Deepwater Horizon.
I would want to know, like, where it would be. I'd want to know how damaging it would be to the environment, if it would have an impact on the local wildlife.
Regulators insist the risk in the Arctic is acceptable. With no easy oil left to find, it is only hard choices from here on out. Miguel Marquez, CNN, Anchorage, Alaska.